In this series, we'll start with the basics and work our way up, exploring each era of the game, opening packs, building decks, and dueling with classic and modern cards. Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out, this series is for you. So stick around because the heart of the cards are calling, and together, we will become true duelists. Welcome to the Garbage Lords Progression Series. Hey, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of the Garbage Lords Progression Series, and we're here. It is Arc V era, I think, right? This is the fifth one. Yeah, this is Pendulum format, and we are opening probably one of the craziest first sets for a series in a long time, Duelist Alliance. This set has like four, debatably five playable archetypes in it, which is just insane. So let's go ahead and not waste any time, get on into it. So first we have the Yang Zings. These are infuriatingly confusing. They can all miss timing, but they are a really powerful synchro engine if you know how to use them. Their monsters all float, and they have some incredibly powerful synchro monsters. Those of you who played Sword Soul would probably know about things like Boxia and other synchro monsters. I forget their names. They're in here, I think. So these guys are incredibly powerful, but as you can see, there's four super rares and I believe two ultra rares, so it's not likely to pull them. We also have Shadals here. Again, really high rarity. Shadal Core and Shadal Fusion are only super rares, so it's not impossible to pull one, but you really do need a critical mass of Shadals before you can play a good archetype. We have Pendulum monsters in here. Now, normal Pendulum is a strategy that a lot of people liked. Not only could you utilize the Pendulums to their fullest because you could pend five every turn, the normal monsters had a high attack stat, they all had effects in the Pendulum scale, but because they were normal monsters, you had so many more Searchers, so each Pendulum had like six copies of each, because you could use Rhoda, you could use Tenki, you could use Fossil Dig, all kinds of methods to get to them, so that was really powerful. Other than that, in the super rare slot, we have Castell, a card that sort of power creeps Honor Arc, but also has its own niche that Honor Arc didn't fill. So it's nice to see that this is an option for, I think we both have Honor Arc at this point, but yeah, if we didn't have this already, it's nice to have it now. Up in the short prints, White Prince is here. That's cool for Skull Servants, but we don't fucking have Skull Servants, so unsurprisingly, we are not going to be looking for this. Other than that, let's see, what else do we have? So we have the Satellar Knights. Satellar Knights are a really powerful rank 4 strategy. They're basically Bujins, but ramped up a lot. They don't have effects in the graveyard, but they have a lot of really powerful effects. This card, Satellar Knight Deneb, is almost certainly one that you need to pull in order to play the deck. If this card is normal, if this card is summoned by any means, add a Satellar Knight monster from your deck to your hand except this card. Really powerful. It's just Stratos for the archetype. You also have Satellar Knight Nova Alpha, which is a really powerful Omni Negate. Just by controlling a face-up Satellar Knight monster, you negate the activation, destroy the card, and draw a card. So it's an Omni Negate that replaces itself. We also have the Shadal monsters here. We only have Construct and Wenda, but they do very quickly come out with more and more. So even if you don't pull any of these, if you pull Fusion and the playable Shadal monsters in the lower rarity, it's very good. We have Saphira, which is a funny card, considering Voiceless Voice is sort of playable right now. But yeah, this card had a lot of people experimenting with it. Here's Qiwen. This is the only tuner in the archetype, so you do need to pull this if you want to play Yang Zing, which we're not guaranteed to do. We also have Felis if you want to play Lightsworns, but God, I hope we don't pull this card. In the rares, here we have the Burning Abyss monsters. Easily the lowest rarity and possibly one of the strongest ones in this set. Now, we only get three here. That's Skarm, Graf, and Seer. But if you know anything about Burning Abyss, you know those are plenty. So hopefully we get these in multiples. We also have UAs. Now, UAs are a really infuriating deck right now, because we get two of them, neither of which can be normal summoned. That being said, Perfect Ace is an Omni Negate, which is incredible, so if we can pull it, that'd be really nice. Here's some more Shadals: Beast, Dragon, and Falco, all three of which are really good. We also have Altair, which is really crazy, really nice card. I played Satellars in Duel Link, so I'm really hoping to pull these. In the Secret Rare here, we have some absolutely, absolutely incredible cards. Rise of the Mega Monarch, while not powerful now, is almost certainly a card that is a ticking time bomb for exactly Fluanderies. Even if you do not pull, like, the secret rares and stuff when we get to Fluanderies, just having this in our back pocket means that we will always be able to play Fluanderies, because, like, Eaglin and Robina were only supers, and Toucan and Stree were commons. I mean, you can play Ryza, you just need to pull one Eaglin, and you can easily do that. Time-Space Trap Pull is a great card for the Trap Tricks archetype. Hopefully we can pull this, considering we do have a good Trap Tricks pool. Oddeye's Pendulum Dragon, while the poster child for Pendulums, is honestly not amazing, but I don't know anything about Pendulums, really. Here we have Boxia, like I said. We have Dante, an absolutely incredible boss monster for the Burning Abyss, and Delteros, which is an incredible boss monster for the Stellar Knights. In the common slot, we have a lot of really important cards. We get Artifact Lancia in here at common. This will be incredible, especially when we get to more banishing heavy strategies. Having Lancia and hopefully a playset of Lancia will be super important. Batteryman 9-volt enables the Batteryman archetype. This deck was almost non-existently like bad until we get exactly 9-volt, and then it's very playable up until like 2015. Resonance Insect is a taking time bomb for the insect strategy. We have more Stellar Knights. We have Monarch Stormforth is absolutely incredible. Hopefully we can pull a playset of this. If we do, then we will be able to play a lot of strategies going forward. Pilgrim Reaper is always a card that I feel like should see more experimentation. It's just mill 5, which is a good card. I think Tierlaments is starting to play around with this card now that Beatrice is banned, but unfortunately hasn't seen too much experimentation. We also got more Shadals. We also have the introduction of the Melodious archetype, which is terrible until we get exactly the Pendulums and Baka. Until then, Melodious is just a very interesting deck that does nothing. But that is going to be the set. Let's go ahead and get on into the opening for today.
Bro, how did we lose? The only saving grace is that at least we get 30 packs of, or 6 extra packs of this, so that brings it to 30. Hopefully get, like, a Castell, some BA cards, that'd be nice. I don't want to play Shadals, especially because I don't think we're going to be able to pull it. We need one Dante, plus the rares, and then that's all we need. So let's get into this 30 packs and just hope and pray. I will re-roll this. Shadal Beast is, like, a decent card. Oh, Lancey's also in this, which is a pretty decent card. Flash Knight. I just realized I was muted. Deltaros, number 2. I was saying that I don't want to play Teller Knights because they're way too high rarity, and Deltaros is, like, only okay. So we got a Shadal Fusion. I don't think we'll be able to make use of it. Another Dwagon. Traveler. Okay. Moving on. Skarm, numero 1, 2? How many do we have? 2 Skarm, and 1 Seer. We want Graph, Seer, Skarm. Graph, Seer, Skarm. Burner Visor. Another Beast. Perfect Deus. Maestra. Another Shadal Fusion, but nothing to make with it. Dragonhorn, something garbage. Graph. I think that's our first Graph. Yeah, it's our first Graph. We want Graph Seer. We got a Dante and a Seer in the close. Okay. That's very interesting. So we have a total of 5 plus a Dante, plus 2 Shadal Fusion plus Traveler, which is not very good. Target any number of BAs in your grave, special summon them in defense. It's just bad Soul Charge. But like, fellas, oh, I didn't even see that we got the Pendy. Double, I don't think that we'll be able to play Teller Knights. I just don't think that deck's very good in sealed. But if we do, we do have like triple and Knuckle Eye. Who knows? I'm going to add this to the collection and I'll see you guys in the deck profile.
We got 24 packs of Duelist Alliance, and I also got Hatch with me. He knows way more about Duelist Alliance than I do.
You're a lot more important than 24 packs of Duelist Alliance. Me.
Yes, exactly. You are important, and you are valid, and I'm glad you're here. Anyways, let's go ahead and flip him up. Dogu.
Dogu! Shouts to Dogu for being the card that, like, every fucking article on Yugipedia recommends you to play, because it can technically search every guy in the game. It's incredible.
Such a funny card. Alright, there's a Bihan. I guess that's not a bad card if we pull a critical mask of Yang Zings, but we do have to pull them.
And they're all super rare and higher.
Yeah, so, they really are. They really are a problem. First Graph and Monarch Storm. And there's a 9-volt.
That's a pretty good one.
That's a good pack. There's a Squamata. Hey, Deneb Delteros. That is pretty good if we can get the Deneb. Deneb is a good card.
Even then, the Delteros is good, like, on its own.
Yang's Incarnation! Let's go! I don't even know what this card is. I've never once looked into
it. It's basically, like, the Yangzing floater effect, but just, like, you get to get another guy out of the deck. So if one dies, you summon two.
Ah, so it sounds like you need multiple of those. It's whatever.
That's kind of the theme for the deck, actually.
Shadal Core. It's not bad. Especially with the dragon in the same pack. Stormforth again. Pretty good. Another Altair. Not bad. I'll take it. We do, again, want to see the Deneb, but if we don't, that's okay. Second Bihan, okay.
Second Bihan, let's go.
Dragon Horn Hunter is not the card we want to see.
No, it's pretty penis.
Yang Zing.
Is that our third perfect ace? What's going on?
It might have been. It was indeed our third perfect ass.
How many,
We must be a modeling agency.
What's the other guy? Is it Slugger?
It's Mighty Slugger, yeah.
How many of that guy have we pulled?
I think it's also a rare.
It is, yeah.
So zero.
It looks like zero right now.
Fuck all. Okay, well, there's a Shadal Fusion. The problem is we don't have any Shadal.
You have a Fusion Monster, but it's nice to have the spell, because you get more Fusion Monsters later.
So the problem here is we've got two Beasts, one Squamata.
Yeah. That's not great.
That is, in fact, a problem. Pendulum Back. Lol.
Pendulum Back. Let's go.
Panzer Dragon. The fourth perfect ace and a second
that
Squamata.
Is your third 9-volt, though. I will point that one out.
There's Dante. The problem is we have one Skarm, two Graph. That is not a playable BA package.
You happen to have any tour guide by chance?
We might. We might have exactly a fifth perfect ace. Oh,
I love
my God.
You so much.
Okay. So I like.
I don't know how to feel about this one.
Yeah, I don't either. I don't
I'm being
like.
Quite honest.
Yeah, I think we're gonna go for it. We're gonna risk it. So let's return to pack select screen.
I think I'm with you on this one, 100%.
24 packs. Let's go ahead and flip them up.
I believe.
There's a Monarch Stormforth and a Knuckle Eye. Not a bad start.
The commons are good. Yeah.
We got Melodious. Melodious is fun.
We sure have a Melodious card.
There's a Vega. I think there's a second Vega already, so that's not bad. A Pualo. Come on, man.
I love Pualo. He's probably my favorite one, because he looks so stupid.
He really does. There's a Seer, at least, and there's a Squamata. Okay, we'll take that. Curse of the Shadow Prison. What the fuck is this card? I've never seen
this. This card's only playable if you're using exactly Super Poly, and even then it's not very good.
Fair enough. Alright. There's our first 9-volt. That's
9-volt's good.
Yep, 9-volt is good. There's a Falco. There's a third Vega. Okay. There's a D.Va. Fun.
Shouts to Battle Guard Howling, by the way. That card's actually really good. Well, I mean, Rage is fine, but it's Howling.
Oh, did I see it? Oh, there it is. Okay.
That one.
target for an attack. Fighting opponent's monster target when facing monster. Oh, okay. That is a pretty good card, especially considering these guys are all warriors. So hopefully we can pull.
And also, the other use case way back in the day was if you were the Shadal player and you're playing like the Protect the Winda game, that card is really good at protecting Winda since it's a spellcaster.
Oh, that's funny. there's our, I think it's our second seer. Second seer, gosh.
Second seer's like fine. The Nine Volt's pretty good.
Squamata.
We got that card. Dog.
Dogu. Okay, come on. All right, can I see a holo? I've seen one super rare, please.
All right. Holos don't exist, actually.
Okay, there's an Altair. That's at least good. Felis, come on, man.
Felis is actually pretty good if you have exactly math nutrition.
I don't, unfortunately. I didn't get math from the
Never Dragon's mind,
Legend set. Monarch Stormforth. Hey, there's a beast. And there's a second Monarch Stormforth. Is that our playset? That's our playset of Stormforth. We have 2 9-volt. That's a... It's playable. Not good, but playable.
It'll be at least, like, around as good as the last time.
There's our Traveler's, place of 9-volt.
Okay. Also, that's the third 9-volt, yeah. Traveler's, like, fine. It's okay.
Now, there's a Skarm. Come on. Give me something good. Second Traveler's not
worth it. Second Traveler, let's go.
There's a Hedgehog and another Squamata. It's a blue baller.
My balls are always blue.
Mighty Slugger. Come on. I've gotten, like, one holo. Second Altair. Great. Please give me a holo.
Yeah, I don't think holos exist in this box.
Please give me a holo. No. Oh, my God.
That's right. We're playing BA. This probably comes to no surprise to anyone because we pulled 5 main deck BAs as well as Dante, a singular Dante. And honestly, that's all we need, buddy. So, this is BA. It's got a little bit more going on, and that's because I, for the longest time, have wanted to bring this zombie brew, just abusing Lavaval Chain, being able to summon a million synchros in one turn and just kill the opponent out of the sun, and just death, destruction. That's all it is. But it turns out that the best zombie cards are Plagues and Mally, who's not even a zombie. So I'm just shoving those into this deck. Mally, as well as Chaos Orc being a 6, is quite nice because then that allows us to go to Pilgrim Reaper, which just mills 5. I thought about putting like Gauntlet Launcher or something else in here, but I'm going to keep it real. We're probably never going to summon this. it's here for funsies. So let's just do the quick card by card, and then we'll jump into Immortal's Demise. So starting off with Dad, of course, it's a dark deck. We're going to play Dad. We can't really modulate levels as much, but we have a lot of ways to get stuff from our hand into the graveyard or vice versa. So it's just a good card in general. After that, we got Chaos Sword. So this is at 2 at this point, and it is a very good card. It's just a banish, and it's a 6. It's quite good. After that, Mally's at 3. This card, in my opinion, should always be at 1, 0, and maybe 2 if hero players cry hard enough, which they always do. I don't think it should ever be at 3. It being at 3 in this format and in modern just leaves it wide open for abuse, and I am not a fan of that. But anyways, my personal opinions aside, this card's very good. Just a level 6 free special from deck. After that, we have Double Plagues. I thought about playing 3, but it's not good at 3. So it's at 2. We want to get this engraved. We don't want to normal this or anything, so yeah. Then we got Double Crane. This just specials a 3 from grave, but negates its effect, so it's like Tour Guide, but from grave. We only have 2 copies, and that's all we need, baby. After that, we got Double Skarm, Double Seer, and 1 graph. So Skarm, or all the BAs have the same first little bit of text, where they're xenophobic. If there's another monster that's not a BA, then they just kill themselves. And then once per turn, if you have no spell traps, you can just special summon it from hand. All the BAs have this first little bit. It's the second bit that makes them unique. Skarm, during the end phase, if this card was sent to the graveyard because it was sent there this turn, you can add a level 3 Dark Fiend-type monster from your deck to your hand, except Skarm. So it's almost always going to be tour guide because it's just a level 3 Dark Fiend. Skarm, search that, but it's got some other utility. Seer, specials from grave. Pretty good. And then graph, specials from deck. So we only have one of this. I wish that we had three of all of these, but we don't. So we'll play another garbage. But we also have tour guide. Tour guide can special summon a level 3 fiend, but negates its effects. So it can special summon these, and since their effects are negated, they don't get popped. Same with the crane. The reason why BA no die is because the effects are negated. After that, we got triple effect veiler. This is our only light outside of the extra deck. But there's so many ways to just like get lights in grave, and it's a very good hand trap. We're just gonna play it. Now we got one burial from a different dimension. Target up to three of your banished monsters, return them to the graveyard. So if we activate Mally, banish, and we have this in hand, we can just activate it. Put Mally back in grave. Mally effect again. Two sixes. Oh, wow. A Pilgrim Reaper. So yeah, that's pretty nifty. But there's a lot of other cool stuff. It just helps us to recover resources. We're probably never going to be returning our Mallies, but we can return stuff that we banished off of Dad or the Chaos Sorc, and most importantly, P Plagues, who banishes himself after he special summons himself. So it's a very good card. Wish we had more, but we don't. We only have one copy and a sat one, so eh. Triple MST because yeah. Triple Soul Charge because yeah. Double Wind Blast, double Raigeki Break. These are just to pitch stuff from hand, mostly. Double Mirror Force, one Bottomless, one Compulse, one Torrential, double Breakthrough Skill. And one Traveler. So Traveler is like a bad soul charge, but is technically searchable, kind of, sort of. We need to mill it first, and then Dante effect it back to hand. That's the only way that we can get this out. But it's a thing. It's pretty good. We're gonna do the extra deck first. So starting off on this side, we've got Pilgrim Reaper. It's just a six. Rank 6. Immortal loves this card, so if any of our longtime viewers don't know what this card does, get good, I guess. So it gains attack equal to the number of dark monsters in either graveyard. You can detach one material, and then both players mill 5. That's it. Yeah. And then we got one Levire. We like to banish things, so if we can just special summon out like a Plagues or something, that's pretty nice. Double Leviathan Dragon. Honestly, I'm playing two of this because I can proactively activate the effect to detach, which will trigger our BA effects because they're just when they're sent to graveyard. So yeah. Then we got Zen Mains. Zen Mains is good but bad. It's honestly just a panic button, and outside of that, we're not going to be using it. And then we have Musarhythm. He just makes himself, when he attacks, he makes himself 3K. So he outs big boys. That's literally it. Alucard pops set. Very good card. I forgot that we had this, but we do. So yeah. Then we got Dante. So Dante, OPT, detach one material, choose 1 through 3. It's always three. Then send that many cards from top of deck to grave until the end of this turn. This card gains 500 attack for each card sent to grave. So basically, he goes up to 25. And then if this card attacks, you change it to defense position at the end of the battle phase. So he will lose the 15 extra attack, but he'll go to defense, so he's not useless. And when he's sent to grave, you can target one BA card in your grave, accept this card, and add it to your hand. Then we got Colossal Fighter. Gains 100 for each warrior, which is exactly Mally. Yeah. But he's good. He's just good. Free specials, very good. Scrap Dragon, a pop. Oh yeah, popping Dante feels so nice with this. You summon this, pop Dante and a card your opponent controls. Then you can Dante target a thing special or add it back. And if you had a Seer attached to it, then you can Seer target Dante, Dante target Seer. special summon back the Dante, and then get the Seer or whatever you targeted with Dante back to hand. Just good. Stardust Dragon to avoid exactly this card, and maybe this card. And this card. Yeah. I just don't want things to pop cards. And then we got Crimson Blader. This is just an 8. That's just it. We can make 7s. It takes 2 3s or a 6 and a Veiler. But we can put the Panic Button Black Rose in here. Then we got one Catastrophe because it's our only good 5 that's like summonable. So he's here. Because we can just make that with any, not any BA, but like a tour guide or a crane plus an effect veiler, or not effect veiler, a plagues. So yeah, then we have Armory Arm, who is veiler plus any 3, and then on to the side. So we've got triple pulling because, in Duelist Alliance, we got Monarch, Stormforth, and I just don't want to have to deal with that shenanigans. So I'm playing that. I could just play Mask, but I would much rather go with Pulling, which has a wider range of applications. Another thing is, like, we get Deskbot stuff, we get Super Heavies. So he might bring a machine build. So I'm just trying to avoid that inevitability by playing System Down. We're also, of course, playing Black Horn of Heaven, the third breakthrough skill. Oh, the reason why we're playing breakthrough skill, one, it's one of my favorite cards of all time, and two, it has an engrave effect where we can just negate something on our turn, which is nice. And then same thing with Mischief of the Yokai. If we mill it, then it still has an application. We also are playing triple DD Crow and Possessed Dark Soul. If he is also on BA, I am siding this in, and then I will search it off of Skarm, normal summon it, tribute, take all of his stuff. That's the theory. I don't think it's very good, or it'll work, but it is here. So yeah, that's the deck. I've said this about the last few decks, but I don't know how he beats this. Actually, there's probably a way that he can beat this by going like, Dark Hole, oh no, here's how he beats it. I summon the Dante. He blaster pitches a freaking guy, a Battling Boxer, pops it, and then I don't have any BAs engraved to target with Dante, and then he just goes, okay, normal summon the guy that special summons back, and then I go, shoot, and then I set up some semblance of board on my turn after he makes Lead Yoke, and then he just goes Dark Hole. And then I cry because he also normal summons a hand after he goes Dark Hole because he just it has everything. And I'm sad. I'm not salty. Anyways, games.
Oh, well, who could have seen this coming? Today we are bringing the Battery Men. This is a sealed play and playground staple. The Battery Men archetype was on and off playable until we got this card right here, Battery Men 9-volt, and to pair with it, the Monarch's Stormforth. Absolutely incredible cards. Let's get straight on into it. So Battery Man 9-volt, when this card is summoned, you can add a Battery Man monster from your deck to your hand, and if you do, this card's attack and defense become doubled, its original. You can only use this effect once per turn, and then during your end phase, you destroy this card. So you would summon this, you would add either Battery Man Charger or Battery Man Fuel Cell. Battery Man Charger, when this card is normal or special or normal summoned, you can special summon one Battery Man monster except itself from your hand or deck, and this card gains 300 attack and defense for each. It is a level 5, so you do have to tribute for it. And then we have Battery Man Fuel Cell. If you control 2 or more face of Battery Man, special this card from your hand. Once per turn, you can tribute a Battery Man monster except for this card, select an opponent's card, and bounce it. And then finally, the big card of the set is Battery Man Micro Cell. The reason I say big is because it kind of just turns the entire deck on. Special summon one level 4 or lower Battery Man monster except for itself on flip. And after this card is flipped up, when it is destroyed by battle and sent to the graveyard, you draw a card. So that is pretty neat. I actually don't know if this triggers off of... This is a weird card, but it is a very powerful card. We got Triple Effect Veiler, a Triple Photon Thrasher. This is just a nice free special in case we want to sack for Charger. And then we got the one Thunder King Ryo because it is a Thunder monster. We have a Battery Charger, which is pay 500 life points, special a Battery Man monster from your graveyard, any Battery Man monster, so we can bring back 9-volt. Darkhold, Triple Instant Fusion. We're making use of this card both as just free tribute fodder for Charger, but also to make rank 5s and Crimson Armor Shadow Ninja if we want. 3 MST, double Pot of Duality, double Rota. Interestingly enough, we can just add Photon Thrashers, Monarch Storm Force, triple Mirror Force, and one Torrential. In the side deck, we got Forbidden Lands, Blackhorn of Heaven, Trap Stun, Vandy's Fiend, and DD Crow. In the extra, we got the one Panzer Dragon for the instant fusion. Panzer Dragon is also pretty neat because if this card is destroyed and sent to the graveyard, target card on the field, destroy it. We can just instant fusion and then just let it die during the end phase. So that way we can just pop another card on the field, pretty neat. Cataster and Black Rose because we can make it with the effect failures. Constellar M7, Digusto Emerald, which we now luckily have thanks to our wild card. Downer Magician, Evigishki Marrowgeist, Symphony Jin, Honor Arc, Crimson Armor Shadow Ninja, Utopia, Rhapsody and Berserk, Utopia Ray, Papal Operative, and Strike Bouncer. I don't even think we can really. Yeah, we can't even make this card. Why are we on it? That's funny. Real quick, let me see if I can pull something together to put in here. You know what, here, we'll put in a Slacker Magician. Just on the off chance we have a Fuel Cell and we can normal summon a Veiler, I think that's better. That is the deck profile for today. Let's get on into the episode. Well, Zach, we're here, and it's official! It's official! No more draw for turn! Yay!
And Lumbastic for all of none for this series.
Yeah, we don't get any good Pendulum monsters for a while, but okay, let's be real. Duelist Alliance was a hell of a set. Like, Pendulums were playable, like, if you had the structured decks, but Shadal, Burning Abyss, Yang Xing, Teller Knights, I mean, four solid archetypes, right? Like, the last time we got a set that in recent memory that was this good was, like, what? Either Agov format, and two of those were from a side set, which was Pearly and Rescue Ace, or it was, it was Tier format. What format was that? That wasn't Agov. That was... What was this? Power of the Elements. That was Pope. Format. Because Pope format introduced Sprite... Tier Lament there's one other set that just didn't.
Mathmech got circular.
Mathmech got circular. Yep, that was the other thing. Is Mathmech got circular?
Thank goodness that card's banned.
I kind of miss it a little bit.
Absolutely do not. I do not miss a one card either OTK or FTK. But I mean, that's just the whole format right now. That's why I'm only playing Edison.
Very true. Okay, honestly, we talked about this a little bit. I've been, like, trying to brew up a White Forest deck for the past little bit. And if I end up going to a Locals tomorrow, I'm high-key thinking I'm just going to bring, like, Cyber Fiendsmith Eldritch. You know, just one Cyber's Gadget makes the whole Fiendsmith line, and then I'll just back it up with a bunch of Eldritch cards like the good old days. I miss that deck. Anyways.
I think you're the only one.
Yeah, I probably am. I miss Eldritch because I almost topped a YCS with it. That's why I miss it. Only reason. But anyways, let's go ahead and get on into this deck and miss other cards. Hey, winning a Dire. You have won a lot of the RPSs lately.
It's because you're only throwing scissors.
Hey, I'm rolling the dice lately. So don't blame me. Blame the dice. All right. Draw phase.
Ooh, we
you
got
don't
special
draw
new
for
zones.
Turn. You figured out how to do the pen zones. Nice.
Yeah. I will go standby, main.
Yay, no draw for turn. Hooray. I love it. Ooh, okay.
Yu-Gi-Oh!
Draw phase, draw for turn, standby, a main phase. All right. You're setting monsters in Duelist Alliance format. That only means one thing. That only means one thing, and that is a Shadal monster right there.
It could be literally anything. Anyways, want a special summon from the extra deck?
No, please? But I think I will Monarch Stormforth here.
Ah.
And I'll stack it for Charger.
Okay, I'll trigger Graph.
Oh, you're playing Burning Abyss. Interesting. Let's see. Sent to the graveyard. Yeah. Sure. Go ahead. So it'd be hold on. More southern, special one battery mode. Yeah, so it's gonna be chain
all
link one.
Skarm.
Yeah, so it'll be chain link one that or chain link one charger, chain link two graph. So we'll go ahead and special out here. After you special the Skarm. What does Skarm do again? I forget.
During end phase, add a level 3 Dark Fiend.
Gotcha, it does nothing.
He does something. He adds Tour Guide.
He does, which I don't think we have for very much longer. Anyways, let's special Battery Man 9-volt and declare 9-volt. Any response? Hello?
Sorry, my headset died.
Oh, you're good. All right. Special 9-volt and effect on of 9-volt to add. Anything in response?
No, you're good.
All right. We'll add this copy of Fuel Cell to hand.
Mm-hmm. The free special.
Yep. We'll special Fuel Cell. Now, here's the question. Do I want to just bounce the Skarm back to your hand? You can't special because you control spell traps right now.
Currently, yes.
Card the opponent controls. Gosh. See, now you're making me worried, because a big part of me thinks that this is just, I'm going to run straight into a Mirror Force right now. But Trap BA isn't a thing. You've got Graf, Seer, and Skarm. Those are your three monsters, so I can't imagine you got too much going on. I mean, I'm going to lose the 9-volt in the end phase anyways. Yeah. Let's declare Fuel Cell. I'll tribute 9-volt to bounce this to hand.
No, not Skarm.
And this is currently gaining gains 3 for each Thunder-type monster you control. So it gains 600. It's going to be 24. Right? Is that how that works? Is that math?
Yeah.
Yes, that's math.
Yeah.
All right. That's math. Battle phase, we'll walk into the Mirror Force.
Yes, you will.
Oh, great. Okay. All right.
Come on, set 4 pass.
No. Second main. I'll do this Arota.
For what? Yeah, go ahead.
I'll add a Photon Thrasher.
Ah, I see.
And then I'll special the Photon Thrasher, just so you have to clear a guy first. You can't just kill me into the sun.
Okay, main phase?
Yep.
Normal summon Crane, target the Graf.
Sure. Its effects are negated, so it doesn't blow itself up. The BA no die.
Why BA no die?
All right. Okay.
Dante.
Okay, you got it. I mean, yeah. If you pull any of the good boss monsters, Malicious. Okay, I'm glad. Double malicious.
Graph effect.
Yeah, you get the graph, sure. Yeah, if you pull any number of Dante construct or God, what's the Citeller Knight XEs that I can never remember the name of. You just have to try and play the deck. You really do. Yeah.
I'm gonna set one.
Sure.
And then activate MST targeting the new set.
What? Okay, sure. Oh, what the fuck?
So I can specials. It's bad soul charge.
Oh, okay.
Special summon Skarm.
Okay, sure. What are you gonna make here, Zen Maze?
I have no clue. Oh, that's funny. Yeah, I'll do that. That's funny.
What the fuck? Hold on.
Actually, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go for Leviathan.
Sure.
I really need to fix this field.
Yeah, you do.
We're going to special in attack.
This is the Crane, the Seer, and the Skarm.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
There we go.
Okay.
And this is at 2-5.
Yes, it is. You milled 3. So now what are you going to do? Is Mally at 3? You tell me.
Mally's at 3.
Okay, so you're going to Mally for Mally and then crank or Levire back to Mally. Oh, no, you can't.
Oh, no, I can't Levire back to Mally.
Yeah, it's level 4 lower monster. So you're just getting the Mally.
Yeah. Battle, swing over.
So I'll take 400 here, 8.
And then
18.
And then set one, pass.
Sure, draw. Standby main.
Oh, also Dante's in defense.
Oh, yep, you can put Dante to defense, that's fine. I'll just T-set and I'll pass.
End phase MST.
God damn it, sure. It's Mirror Force.
I'll draw.
Mm-hmm.
Standby main.
Yep.
To attack you, Dante, I'll detach the Crane.
Sure. Good.
Whoops.
Okay, well, I'm glad to see that as well.
Oh. Ooh, a plague effect.
Sure. Stack a card.
These two for...
Stardust, I'm assuming. It's probably Stardust. Hmm.
I think it's just better to go for Crimson Blader.
That's a problem. That's a problem right there.
And, of course, the plague is banished.
Yep.
I'll just go battle. Mm-hmm. I'll hit the 2-5 in.
Sure. So it's going to be Microcell. Trigger Microcell.
Sure. So yeah, that's
level
fine.
4 lower battery mount monster from my deck. Except itself, of course. And then after this card has been flipped up, when it is flipped face up, when it's destroyed, balance into the graveyard, you draw a card. Cool. So I guess, I mean, the answer is just, of course, we special summon. Oh, gosh. Okay, so I guess we special summon 9-volt in defense. Mm-hmm. So this goes to grade, and then we draw a card, and then on resolution, I get 9-volt effect. I think that's how that works. So I'll draw my card, and then we will go ahead and get 9-volt to add a battery man. Let's add...
Accept himself,
yeah. Normal or special summon, you jerk. Okay. Let's add a copy of... Shit, I guess we'll just add Charger to hand.
Okay.
And this is at 2000. So what'd you hit in with? I'm assuming it's Crimson Blader. Yep.
Yeah.
So then Crimson Blader destroys Sensitive Graveyard, and they'll take another 18. So I'm locked out of normal and special summoning level 5 or cool. Higher.
Main 2. I will Levire detach Skarm.
Target plagues. And then is that to get the Skarm effect, Skarm I effect. Assume?
Yes.
See, you could be really funny and resolve Skarm. Yeah. You could be really funny and go Plagues and Crimson Blader into Leo, Keeper of the Sacred Tree.
I could.
But you're not going to.
But I won't. And this is in defense. You're good to go.
All right. Draw phase, draw for turn. Standby, main phase. All right. So there's two problems in front of me right now. Actually, it's Dante really isn't a problem. Now that you've wasted the materials on it, I just don't do anything with it, and then it never goes to graveyard, so you never get the Seer Dante loop online. Which you can't even get the Seer Dante loop online currently, because Seer's stuck under Levire, which is neat. So now,
also, Seer Dante loop isn't really good until...
Very true.
Yeah, later.
Yeah. Okay, so I think... just an asshole, isn't he? Ugh. Yeah. All right, I think that's the play. All right, so we're going to activate Battery Charger. I'll pay 500 to special a Battery Man monster from my graveyard.
Yeah, summoning the 9-volt, I'm assuming.
Yep.
Because it's your only legal target besides Microcell.
I could summon the Microcell. I could.
Yeah, but Microcell's bad.
It is. It is a very bad card to just summon. Okay. It doesn't negate the effects, interestingly enough, so I can trigger the Microcell, or the 9-volt, which I guess there's no harm in doing.
Yeah, it deck thins.
It does. So we'll add a Fuel Cell to hand. And now I gotta think here. Yeah, I think that's probably, oh, thank God, this is tough, but I think this is probably better. We're going to normal summon Thunder King Ryo.
And then overlay?
Yep.
Yeah!
We're going to overlay for, oh gosh, okay, hold on, I gotta think here. Well, it doesn't matter. If this gets Veilored, this gets Veilored. We're going to go for Honor Arc and declare the effect attaching both.
Mm-hmm. For Crimson Blader?
Yeah, I got to take the Crimson Blader.
Yeah, I assumed as much.
Neat. All right. Battle phase. I will clear the Leviathan.
Okay.
Actually, do I want to clear the Leviathan or do I want to clear the Plagues? No, if I keep the Plagues online, then you literally can't summon BAs. Which is better.
Seer effect targeting Skarm.
Sure.
Special Skarm.
Skarm gets blown up.
Skarm gets blown up. Yep. And then Skarm will trigger during the end phase.
Yep. So I've normaled, I've specialed, I've beaten the Crimson Blader, luckily. Don't really have anything else to
for
do.
For now.
Yeah, for now. Second main, I guess, go ahead. I don't have much else to do, so.
This goes back on top because in the end phase I need Skarm. Skarm.
Mm-hmm. Go for Skarm.
I will just grab another tour guide.
Okay, so you have a tour guide, yep.
So. And I'll draw.
Yep.
Main one.
Mm-hmm.
Normal summon tour guide effect.
Sure.
We will special summon.
Yeah, what do you get here? Because all the BAs.
Just another tour guide.
Ah, that's fair. Mm-hmm.
I will then synchro summon for Scrap Dragon.
Why don't you read the last line of the tour guide?
You're right. I realized that as soon as I put the guy on board.
I wish this card could be used for synchros. That'd be crazy.
That'd be very fun. We just do that.
What do we make, like Zen mains or something?
Could just do that. Or that. I think that's more correct, yeah. Did you forget about Leviathan?
I didn't forget about it. I was just like, that seems substantially worse than just clearing the Honor Arc.
Okay. I'll switch the Dante to attack.
Sure.
I'll go battle and then crash Dante.
Oh, I will get the Dante effect. Yeah, 11. Take 11. Mm-hmm.
And then Dante effect targeting the Traveler.
Sure. Oh, the trap. It is any card, yeah.
And then I'll get the Crimson Blader off that.
Yeah, so I'll take 400.
I'll go main to special summon Seer. Seer will die. Mm-hmm. Seer effect target Dante.
Sure.
Set one, end phase. I did not Skarm pass.
All right, so the Traveler does what again? You gotta remind me.
It's literally Soul Charge for BAs.
Okay, But you can only summon two. Okay, sure. Draw phase, draw for turn.
No, it's summon any number of BAs.
Oh, it's summon any number of BAs. But, well, you only have two spots available is what I mean.
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. That's interesting. That's very interesting, actually. Standby main phase. Okay, there's a couple things I can do here, but I gotta think this through first. That doesn't matter. So we're not gonna do that. Yeah, okay, so then that's just better. I'm at 23, yeah. Okay, so Leviathan Dragon is what we in this industry call a mild problem. Just a mild,
kind of big.
Just a little one. Okay, so we go that special. Oh, that's neat. Okay, that's nice. So we go that special, that grab that. Okay, yeah. All right. Instant fusion.
Sure.
Summon out Panzer Dragon.
Mm-hmm.
And then this will go to grave. We'll sack it for Battery Man Charger. Chainlink 1 yep. Charger.
Yeah.
I believe, yep, both of those are in the graveyard. So we'll special summon this Battery Man 9 Volt from hand. Trigger 9 Volt.
Mm-hmm.
2000. We'll grab another copy of Fuel Cell to hand.
Mm-hmm.
Special summon Fuel Cell. And a special summon Fuel Cell.
Yep.
Okay. This charger is going to be buffed a lot. It's going to gain 3, 6, 9, 12. So it'll be at 3K.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then now the issue still comes down to how do I clear this board? Except this card. No. Okay, so we're gonna go declare Fuel Cell. I really don't want to give you the Dante.
Give me another Dante, back. Please.
Yeah, this is the problem. It's I don't want to give you another Dante, but it's either I give you the Dante in the extra deck or I give you
the Dante in the grave.
Yeah.
But a Dante in the extra deck is basically a Dante in the grave.
Pretty much. Cause I'm trying to think. Cause the thing is, I go bounce one of the X's. It's one of the X's. I'm never bouncing the plague back to your hand because then I just can't clear your board. Mm-hmm. So I do that. The second I clear the Leviathan with Charger, or I clear the other X's with Charger. You take a little bit of damage. I hit over the plagues, and then you can bring back four. If you bring back four, then I literally cannot allow you to make a second Dante because I'm not going to be able to clear them all. Because some of mm-hmm. these have pretty big defenses, don't they? Yeah, Scarm is 2K.
Mm-hmm.
And Sears 15. Okay, so I think it's Tribute 9 Volt because this one's going to grave anyway at the end of the turn. I'll put back the Leviathan.
Okay.
We'll go to battle phase.
This is now at 27.
27. Still big enough, importantly. Yes. But yes, it is going to be smaller. Whenever DB wants to catch up. There we go. We'll clear the Dante.
Okay. Dante effect for Seer.
Sure. And then, What if I just leave the plagues on the field?
You could.
I very much so could. What's the danger? You have a seer in hand. Next turn you go like normal seer special Dante, and then I mean you just have that loop online. It's just that back row that's giving me like the hardest of hard times right now. Oh, I should have done that. Oh, that wouldn't have worked anyway. So God, this is like so annoyingly difficult right now. But this plagues, I can tell, is giving you a lot of trouble as well.
Not really, honestly. I like having it on the field.
That's fair. The second I clear the plagues, you traveler for... Can it summon Dante as well?
Yes.
Okay, so the moment I clear the plagues, you do this for four.
So it has to summon ones that were sent there this turn. So currently the only target is Dante.
Oh, okay. That does change things then. Yeah, okay. I won't be able to hit over the Dante again, though, which is the problem. Yeah, I guess we'll just... I don't like doing it, but yeah, let's clear this with Silent Honor Arc.
Okay.
Attempt 21 direct.
I will target the Dante.
This is 25 booty, no redeclare.
Sure, you don't want to lose four?
Second main phase, you have a seer in hand. I don't know the other card, do I?
It's tour guide, you know.
Oh, it's tour guide. Okay, so then I definitely can't do the play that I wanted to do. Let's do this. Yeah, I don't like doing this, but it's probably correct.
You get a man, make it a six.
I'm thinking about it. There's a couple sixes. Is the six better than the two fuel cells, though? That's the question we have to ask ourselves. I think it is, just because it's bigger than Dante. Yeah. We'll overlay for strike bouncer.
For sure.
This will go down to 21. And charger attacked and strike bound or and honor arc attacked. So I will just pass the turn there.
I will draw.
Yep.
I will go standby main.
Yep.
I will set one mile to hand. I will special summon Seer.
Sure.
Set one.
Sure.
And then pass.
Sure. Draw. Draw phase. Let's see what that is.
Ooh, that sucks.
Yeah, that does suck. But it's not bad. Okay, so what's the order I need to kill these in? Target one Burning Abyss monster, except Seer, special it. Target a Burning Abyss card in your graveyard, add it to your hand. So Dante gets, so I need to kill Seer. Seer brings back Graf. Graf can bring back, are these once per turns?
No. Well, some of them. Dante isn't, but the others are.
Okay, so basically I've got to kill... Oh, I can't even kill it then. It's tour guide. I know it's tour guide. I go kill Seer, you bring back Graf. I kill Graf, you bring back Seer. I kill Seer. Seer doesn't bring back anything. Is that, am I thinking that's correct? Because it says you can only use one effect of Seer this turn and only once that turn. So yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Standby main. We'll go battle. Attack Honor Arc into Seer.
Okay. Seer effect.
Mm-hmm.
Special back. Skarm.
Ooh, Skarm. Okay. Kill Skarm.
Okay.
And then...
I don't know.
Kill Dante.
Yeah, Dante effect.
Yep.
Or Seer.
Sure. Second main. Do I even want to, like, set anything? I don't think so. Jeez, I kind of backed myself into a pretty shitty corner here, but I'm just going to set a card. And I'll pass.
Okay, I'll draw.
Mm-hmm.
Standby main.
Yep. Oh, did you mean to Skarm last turn?
Oh, I did, yes. I'll put this back on top.
Yeah, then. I'll let you do it. I forget if you declared Skarm, but I'm sure you meant to.
Oh, wait, no, I can't Skarm. Never mind.
Are you out of targets?
Maybe.
We may be out of targets for Skarm. Okay, good to know. Oh, all right. After a very back-and-forth game one, let's get into the sided games. I think these will hopefully be quicker, but who knows. Okay.
I will go main.
Sure.
Set.
Mm-hmm.
Pass.
Sure, draw. Standby main. Well, this is going to be very reminiscent. I will set, and pass.
Sure, I'll draw.
Mm-hmm.
I'll MST the middle.
It's annoying, but it's fine. It's a Monarch Stormforth.
I'll pass.
Sure, draw. Standby main. I will set yet another card and pass.
Sure, I'll draw.
Mm-hmm.
Main one.
Sure.
Normal summon graph.
Sure.
Battle phase. 1,000 total big ones.
I'll take 1,000. Sure, draw.
Pass.
Standby a main phase. Let's... Bring this monster from your deck, except itself. That's crazy. That is craziness. I'll Stormforth here.
Okay.
And I'll sack it for Charger. Attempt to activate Charger effect.
I'm gonna chain link two graph, chain link three breakthrough skill.
Breakthrough skill, huh? I'll chain trap stun to that.
Okay.
Alright, so breakthrough skill fail. Oh. Breakthrough skill resolves negated. Graph summons out Skarm, and this summons out 9 Volt. New chain, declare 9 Volt effect.
I'm going to chain Veiler.
You know, Veiler the 9 Volt. Interesting. Fair and interesting. So 9 Volt, importantly enough, will not get destroyed this turn because... it didn't act. Its effect didn't resolve.
Mm-hmm.
Well, its effect is negated, so during the end phase, it just can't be destroyed. Okay, so that's not how that works. But anyway, okay.
Gonna punch and deal 1,000 big ones to me.
I could. The problem is I don't really want to. This is at 21. Importantly.
Mm-hmm.
I could. The problem is I really don't want to give you Skarm effect.
Yeah, well, why not? I can be trusted with a Skarm effect. What are you talking
see,
about?
See, the thing is, I don't think you can.
He's on to us, boys.
Alright, I think that this is the play. I don't like this play, but I think this is the play. We'll special fuel cell.
Sure.
We are going to make sure I'm not doing something stupid. No, I'm not. Okay. We will declare fuel cell tributing 9 volt to return this to hand.
Sure. Okay.
Instant fusion, pay 1,000.
Sure.
Summon Panzer Dragon, and then overlay Panzer Dragon and Charger. Oh, wait, I can't do this, can I? Because I have Stormforth this turn. Yep, I can't do that.
Mm-hmm.
That is fine to hand. So, giving you free information, but that's fine.
And you gain 1,000 back.
Yep. Two extra deck with that. Gain 1,000. Alright. Yeah. We'll just go battle phase.
Punch for 42?
Yeah. I'll punch for 21-21. 21-21, not worth living it. Ah, here's, that song's dead. Anyway, second main. Yeah, go ahead.
I'll draw.
Yep.
Standby main.
Mm-hmm.
Weird line of play, but soul charge.
Oh, okay. Paying.
Or one.
You're gonna pay 1,000. Thinking here, I actually do have a response to soul charge possibly. So it just special summons the number of monsters. I know you have a Skarm in hand. Yeah, I'm gonna
gonna crow it.
I am actually gonna crow the graph.
Okay.
I was holding the crow for the possible.
And I do not lose the life points, and I can use my battle phase.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh wait, hold on. You cannot conduct your battle phase the turn you activate this card.
Oh.
So you won't get a battle, but you don't lose the life, yep. Alright.
Set pass.
Draw. Standby main. Now we can do the funny thing. Battery charger. Pay 500.
Sure.
Special 9-volt, 9-volt effect.
I'm gonna pulling.
Normal summoned. This was specialed.
Oh... Right.
So go to.
For some reason, I thought that it was just when it was activated an effect on summon.
There is a card that I think does that. I think that's a.
There's one that does it on special, and there's one that does, and this one does it on normal. For some reason, I thought that pulling just did both.
I think Trap Trick Chapel Nightmare does both.
Yeah, I don't have that card.
Yeah, that's fair. we'll add. I don't think there's like any funny way we can do this. I think it's just fuel cell. We'll special summon fuel cell. Are you dead here? I think you are.
I'm literally dead here if you bounce the set.
Yeah. We'll declare tribute the 9 volt. And then just to be safe, not BMing at all. Special Panzer.
Literally is BMing.
take 1,000 overlay for Crimson Armored Shadow Ninja. I'll be it down 1,000 more. And then battle phase 21, 24, and 21.
Yeah, it's game.
Okay. So yeah, you played BA. you have an insanely strong BA pool. What was that like?
I have 5 main decks and 1 Dante.
I mean,
that's my BA pool.
That's still really good. I mean, Graf, Seer, Dante is kind of enough. Both Graf and Seer go to 1 eventually. So, like, mm-hmm. That's kind of enough. And then, like, the truth is, like, we only have three BA names, I think, right now. But literally every set for the next, like, four or five sets, we get more. So
I want to see your deck so I can see just how hard I got sacked this second game by double freaking Stormforth plus Charger.
I do have a full Battery Man deck, so I don't know if you got sacked too hard.
But, I mean, it's like the Stormforth plus that, plus you already had a Fuel Cell in hand.
Yeah, having the Fuel Cell in hand was a little sacky, I'll admit it.
Having the Fuel Cell and the Trap Stun?
Yeah, the Trap Stun. So shoutouts to Hatch for helping me build this deck, because I was dead tired when we tried to build this. He was like, oh, just play Trap Stun. Trap Stun's kind of good. And you played Trap BA, so that's pretty good. but no, this, okay, the Chaos BA stuff is really funny.
I just couldn't find, like, anything. I was sitting on, like, terrible dead hands.
Yeah, Crane, you got Tour Guide. Don't you have Mathematician?
I don't think I have any Mathematician.
I thought you did. Well, I guess Mathematician's more of a Shadal card than...
I don't have Math.
Ah, that's unfortunate. So, okay, let's talk about our pulls for this episode. So I got Dog Water, right? And I will be honest, I'll be honest to you and the viewers. I had to redo my pulls several times, okay? Literally. So the first time I did it, I did my pulls. I did them. They were, like, pretty solid, right? But I wasn't, So the first time I did it, I forget something went wrong. I think I wasn't signed in. Yeah, I wasn't signed into my YGO Pro account, which meant when I went to sign in, it just cleared all the polls. Second time I did it, I had signed in, but I had signed into the wrong account. Third time I did it, I didn't record the polls. And the fourth time I did it, I finally did it right, and I got the worst pulls possible. No Shadal fusions, no Satellar Knights, just the worst BA pool, like, possible. I pulled so poorly. I pulled the Wind Yangzing, like, six times across, like, all the openings. It was so bad. It was so bad. So I was like, well, that's what you get for not being prepared, is you just get shitty pulls. But it seems like yours were quite good. So
yeah, but it didn't mean much, because it's like, what, I have five BAs, and then I just need to throw in a bunch of other crap. And it's like, stuff like in testing, it was pretty dang consistent. I don't know if this was just variance or what, but like, my hands were not super great both games. Mm-hmm. I just wasn't finding a decent mix of spell trap plus monsters.
Gotcha.
And it was towards the end of the first game, I was only drawing monsters when I should theoretically, since I had like no monsters left in deck, be drawing spell traps.
Yeah. Also, like, you don't have that many live mills when we look at it. What, it's Breakthrough Skill, Plague Spreader, the BAs, obviously, and then Mally.
It's mainly just trying to set up for Chaos.
Chaos plays, yeah.
And then I was siding in some other stuff that I didn't do for this game.
Yeah. I mean, you lost this one, but the truth is, like, you have an insanely strong BA pool, like, going forward. Just having Dante makes BA playable. So, like, the further we get into Arc V, the more playable your BA pool is going to be, and the scarier this deck is going to get. On the flip side, I think Battery Man is playable now, and then it very quickly, like, dives off in terms of playability, because why would you bother tribute summoning a Battery Man Charger when you can just set pen scales and pendulum out five every turn? Why would you bother setting a Fuel Cell when you can set a Shadal Squamata, you know, all that kind of stuff? It's just, this deck gets power crept so insanely quickly. It's literally just the combination of Stormforth plus Charger that's insane.
And you had that both games, which like hurts a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I tried to like mitigate that, but there's only so much you can do when, like, you just have what you need in the deck.
Yeah. which I was lucky enough to get a playset of charger and a place or playset of fuel cell. And so I have a playset of fuel cell, playset of charger, playset of 9-volt, which we got this episode, and a playset of Stormforth, which was surprisingly enough not guaranteed. I mean, of all commons are never guaranteed. We all know that. But yeah, I'm scared of your BA pool going forward, but what I'm not scared of is the winner's wheel for today's episode. So let's get on into that. All right, so we got the winner's wheel here. Let's go ahead and give it some clicks. I'm just going to roll a dice because I don't care. 5 clicks. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let's see what we get. 5 clicks for the number of stars on Charger. And another super rare wild card ticket for me. I don't even know what I can get in super rare. I think there might be Castell. Yeah, Castell's probably it. Castell's like an insane rank 4. But we'll find out in the next episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like. If you really enjoyed, make sure to subscribe. That's all from us. We'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.